Hello everyone, welcome back to the chapter 15 of hematology, that is iron deficiency anemia. If you want the notes of the video, you can follow us on Instagram and you can message us so that you can get the PDF form of the notes.
Iron deficiency anemia. Commonest nutritional deficiency disorder present throughout the world. Whenever they say anemia, most commonly this is what they mean. Now, iron metabolism, before understanding all the different things, we should first know how the iron metabolism takes place. Actually I have uploaded a video where I have explained iron metabolism in detail. I'll link it in the description as well as in the iBitten. You can go and read or study that before starting this. It would be more helpful, whereas in this I can tell you in short about it. Iron loss per day is usually 1 milligram per day in adults, males, and in females who are not menstruating, who have attained the menopause, they usually have 1 mg per day iron loss, whereas in the females who are menstruating, they usually have 1 to 2 mg per day loss. Now, whenever we say iron, which is needed in a body, the body has two primary sources for iron. The first one is the food which contains iron, means the food which we eat through which we get the iron. And second one is the recycling of the iron from senescent RBCs. Senescent means the old RBCs which are destroyed, and the iron from that. Those are the two sources of iron. Now, when we come to iron metabolism, we need to understand about iron absorption, iron transport, and iron storage. In absorption, you should always remember that only ferrous form of iron, that is Fe2+, is absorbed by our body. So in the most common region where the iron is absorbed in a body, you should remember it is our duodenum. So duodenum is a place where iron is absorbed. Okay, so in absorption, you better watch the video, you will get a complete idea. Fe2+ is absorbed duodenal cells. DMT, one that is divalent metal transporter, it takes the Fe2+. So as we have both Fe2, that is ferrous, and Fe3+, that is ferric, both in our food, which Fe3+ is converted to Fe2+ by cytochrome C reductase, and from the cells to the circulation, it is sent by ferroportin. And there the Fe2+ is changed to Fe3+, which is required by hephaestin. So this is a complex, you can just check that. If I won't be discussing it in this video much, so this is what you need to know. So these are very important for the absorption of our iron. So in iron absorption, the factors which increase the iron absorption are HCl, ascorbic acid, which is also a vitamin C, amino acids, and carbohydrates. These increase the absorption of iron in our intestine. Whereas factors which decrease the iron absorption are phytates. Phytates, which are also called, which are all the vegetables which we have, they decrease the iron absorption. And in tannins, such as tea, coffee, wine, chocolate, even they decrease our iron absorption. And even the carbonates also decrease our iron absorption. So in iron absorption, these factors increase the iron absorption and these decrease the iron absorption. Now let's understand the iron transport. Iron is absorbed, and how it, you should always remember transferrin. Transferrin is like the bus which takes the iron. So normally, let's understand, there is a bus which has 6 seats. So iron, what iron usually takes only two sheets. Means if there is iron, it attaches only to the two things. So normally transferrin, this transferrin is it transports the iron. So normally transferrin is 1/3 saturated. See, in 6 only two sheets are taken by iron. So normally only 1/3 part is only saturated. So percentage transferrin saturation, the saturation is only 33%. Total ion binding capacity means the ion which is binds to the transferrin, that is the total ion binding capacity, and in normal individuals it is 300 to 360 mg per deciliter. So this is very easy to understand. Transferrin is very important for the transport of iron. Now we come to the storage of iron. Mainly iron is stored in liver and bone marrow. In circulation, this Fe3+, it attaches to the apoferritin to form ferritin, which is stored in the form of ferritin and hemosiderin in liver and bone marrow. So iron is stored in liver and bone marrow. Now what exactly happens in anemia, that is our iron deficiency anemia? We learnt about the absorption of iron, about the transport of iron, and about the storage of iron. Now if there is any problem in all the three, if there is any problem, that leads to anemia. So the cause of the iron deficiency anemia is reduced iron intake. If you don't take proper food, iron containing food, then it leads to anemia. If there is increased iron requirement, means in cases of pregnancy, in infants and in children, whenever there is increased iron demand, that at that time you can see, and there is no supply, you can see the iron deficiency anemia. And whenever there is increased loss, such as blood loss, in worm infestations and all other forms, if there is increased iron loss and decreased absorption. So if there is any problem in all these four, it leads to iron deficiency anemia. Development of anemia progresses in three stages. First is the storage iron depletion, means the iron which is stored in the bone and liver, these are all depleted, these are all used up, and there is it is not compromised by the supply, means there is no enough supply and even the present iron is depleted. And next what happens is iron deficient erythropoiesis. Here mainly kidney failure, or if there is any problem in stimulation of erythropoietin, means erythropoietin causes erythropoiesis. So if there is any problem with the erythropoietin enzyme, then it leads to iron deficient erythropoiesis. And usually in the frank, if there is blood loss or any loss where there is direct loss of iron, that leads to anemia. So these are the three stages which takes place. Now we come to the clinical features. First thing, you see pallor, because anemia you can see the pallorness, there is no much, the skin looks pale. Dyspnea, because there is breathlessness in the patient, because he is not getting enough oxygen. Palpitation, that is nothing but there is tachycardia is seen. This is usually because due to lack of oxygen, and means oxygen, there is no lack of oxygen, but the oxygen uptake is reduced because of iron deficiency anemia. So the heart has to beat faster. Coelonchia, it is nothing but spoon shaped nails. This is some of the systemic features of iron deficiency anemia. You can see the spoon shaped nails, and this pica is seen in children. So this is some of the clinical features which you can see in iron deficiency anemia. Now let's come to the hematological parameters. Now you know in bone, I said iron reserves are mostly in the bone marrow. So in bone marrow, ferritin levels, it usually leaks the ferritin. So serum ferritin, if you check the serum ferritin, you in turn you understand the bone marrow ferritin levels. So in iron deficiency anemia, decreased serum ferritin, it is the most specific test which suggests that there is iron deficiency anemia. Now obviously there is depletion, then the serum iron, the iron in the blood is also reduced. So serum ferritin is reduced, serum iron is reduced. Now see what happens is there is the transferrin, which saturation is also reduced because the blood there is no enough ferritin to take place. So the saturation, matlab there is no iron itself. So the saturation itself is reduced, and once the this transferrin, it knows that the saturation is reduced, it thinks that it needs more vehicles to take the iron, and there is, we need more. So that is the reason the binding capacity, the capacity is increased, but there is no iron to bind to it. Whenever there is iron deficiency, the maturation is not so proper, and the cells, they do not maintain their normal and they become very small. So that is why they are microcytic. And due to pallidness and hemoglobin concentration reduction, hypochromic. So this iron deficiency anemia is microcytic hypochromic anemia. Whereas there is no much iron, the size, they are not so regular. The size is, some are small, some are big. So it is not maintained. So you can also see anisocytosis. Means there is variation in size of the RBCs. You can also see poikilocytosis, which means there is the proper biconcave shape is not maintained by the cell. Now next we come to the MCV, that is mean corpuscular volume. That means the volume of the RBC. Now as these are microcytic, though indirectly the volume, if the microcytic means the cell size is reduced, means the volume is also reduced. So mean corpuscular volume is reduced. In MCH, that is mean corpuscular hemoglobin, as there is pallidness, hemoglobin is reduced. So the corpuscular hemoglobin is reduced. MCHC is mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. See, cell is also reduced, cell size is reduced, hemoglobin is reduced. So in turn, hemoglobin concentration in the cell is also reduced. Now usually, again, one thing you see is in normal RBC, whenever there is iron deficiency anemia, in normal RBC, you can see there is a central paleness is there, and the outer peripheral side has hemoglobin. This is normally what is seen. But in iron deficiency anemia, the central paler, there is no central paler, and just you can look like a dot like structure. So the central paleness, which is seen in normal, is not seen in iron deficiency anemia. Now we come to the investigation. Obviously, we should first know the cause. If the there is no particular iron intake, or if there is loss of blood due to GIT issues such as hemorrhoids or any other issues, we should check for that by doing stool examination for the blood. And as I have told earlier, serum ferritin, total iron binding capacity, percentage transferrin, serum iron, that is all in CBC and hemoglobin. These all help you in concluding the diagnosis. In differential diagnosis means what are the other diagnoses you can see, such as mainly the other variations are nothing but the microcytic hypochromic anemias, such as anemia due to chronic disease, sideroblastic anemia, because these both have the microcytic hypochromic anemias. So it gets difficult sometimes, but these parameters such as serum, these help you to differentiate. Next is the treatment. First thing, know the cause and correct it. If there is reduced intake, give iron dose and all that. You should check for worm infestation. If there is some worm infestation and all, you should first treat that. And the most common is the oral iron therapy. The most common is ferrous sulfate, which is given. For adults, usually 150 to 200 mg per day is given, and for children 3 mg per kg, means depending upon the weight of the child, the iron is calculated. Now once you have given, and you should even though the when you check the hemoglobin on all parameters after giving oral iron therapy, it is normal, but yet you should continue, means after correction for 4 to 6 months, you should continue the oral iron therapy so that all these stores which were depleted should come back to normal and should be stored. So you should continue the treatment for 4 to 6 months of the oral iron therapy. Whenever there is severe iron deficiency anemia, usually, and the patient there is more severe condition, parenteral iron therapy is considered. That is, giving iron supplement like directly through intravenous. Usually intramuscular is not, intravenous is mostly given. And how you should calculate is weight of the person into 2.3 into 15 minus his hemoglobin, which is in gram per deciliter, and add 50 minus the 1000. This is because of the replenishing for the iron stores. So this is how it is calculated. I know this was a long video, but anyway, iron deficiency anemia is a very important chapter, and it is very commonly seen as a clinical practice. It is very important to know the lab investigation parameters, the hematological parameters. So this was it. Thank you for watching the video.